So in the last session, we were discussing about cross product and also about the application of dot product in finding out the projections or components of one vector parallel to another vector or perpendicular to another vector. So we will begin today with some example questions based on the same, and then we will move on to also see some applications and further concepts related to cross product. Okay. So let's start with a quick recap of the concept of projections that we learned last time. So if we saw if we have two vectors A and B like this, okay, then we saw that we can draw the component of the vector A parallel to vector B, that is this component here. And we can also draw the component of A perpendicular to B. That is a component which will be along the line perpendicular. So that will become this. So the method that we discussed was that this is so using this, we find out this parallel component. And once we have got the parallel component, the perpendicular component simply becomes a vector A minus the parallel component. Because you can see is this. So this is what we saw about the two projections last time. Okay, so we'll discuss some questions related to this. And then next we moved on to see the concept of cross product. So let me take you through that also. So we saw that A cross B is defined as AB sine theta n cap, where n cap is the unit vector perpendicular to both A and B by the right hand palm rule. And we also saw that if we have A and B in component form, we can express the cross product in general using a three-dimensional matrix. Solving the determinant of the matrix, we get the value of the cross product like this. Okay, so this is the component form, and that above one is the formula. Okay. So let us start with some examples with the applications of all these things today. Okay, start with this question, please. Solve this and let me know the answer. Yeah, we to answer your question, your major test doubts. If you look at your timetable, we have a doubt session later in this week, and we'll discuss the doubts from the test with that. Yeah, Prince, write down the question. Okay, and start solving it. Veer, that is not a logical question. You don't know which projection you have to find, then how you will find the projection? Just solve the question which I have given you now. That's why I'm giving you questions, so that you understand these kind of things, Veer. Okay, I'm just putting up the answers for this question. So those of you who solved it, verify it first, and then I'll explain the solution. So the answer for A part okay, so hope you're getting this, most of you. Yeah, Dushant, I've already mentioned that I will be taking up the doubts of the major test in the doubt session. If you look at your timetable, we have a separate doubt sessions this week. So let us keep all that for that session, because otherwise, what is the point of having a doubt session? Yes, I'll explain part B. Okay, first, try it yourself. Okay, so the proper answer for the second part actually will be that C can be plus minus of this vector. I'll explain why. So C can in fact also be minus of this whole vector. So it can be this. So there are two possible options for C. So anyway, let's understand this in more detail. So there's something interesting about this question, which is why I've given you these values exactly. See, the vector A was given to us as 3i cap plus j cap minus k cap. And the vector B was given as 2i cap minus j cap minus k cap. Okay. So if you look at this now, you realize something interesting. A cos theta, which is A dot B divided by mod B, is actually root 6. Are you getting this, people? As you can see from here, A dot B is equal to 6 and mod B is root 6. So interestingly, note here what is happening. A cos theta is equal to mod B. So that means the vector triangle formed by A and B is a right angle triangle. Okay, and that's why, and hence you are getting A's parallel component as B itself, because A's parallel component, which is A cos theta times B cap, is from here from this, it is just B vector. Okay. So if you thought it's very odd why this is happening, that the parallel component is equal to the second vector only, the reason why this is happening is because these two particular vectors are such that this is the way they are oriented. Okay, so let's understand that geometrically. So iska matlab kya hai ki A and B are two vectors such that this is the vector B, and its magnitude is root 6. The vector A itself is like this. So when you drop a perpendicular, this angle is 90 degrees. Okay, so that is why you can see this happening. So you can see what is mod A from here. Okay, so that's okay. So that is why you can see in this diagram what is happening is your parallel component of A is actually coinciding with B. Okay, and the perpendicular component will be this one. So just subtract these two vectors. So A and B are not perpendicular to each other. It just means that when you draw A and B together from a common origin and drop this perpendicular, it automatically forms a right angle triangle. अरे ई डॉट भी ऐसे आता है बाबा, व्हाई यू पीपल फॉरगेटिंग ऑल दीज बेसिक थिंग्स फ्रॉम हियर. योर ई डॉट बी इज ए एक्स बी एक्स प्लस ए वाई बी वाई प्लस ए जेड बी जेड. सो ए एक्स बी एक्स इज हाउ मच, इट्स 3 × 2. ए वाई बी वाई इज हाउ मच, 1 × −1, and AZ BZ is how much? −1 × −1. So kitna aaya? 6 − 1 + 1. So 6 aaya ki nahi? You can't forget what we have done 2 lectures back, na? You prepared all this for the major test also. Dot product was part of it. Yeah, but Prince, the magnitude of magnitude of vector is coming. Okay, got it. Yeah, that's correct. Just make a correction, people, for magnitude of the vector E. That's as you can see, that is becoming square root of 9 + 1 + 1. Okay, so that's √11. Okay. But anyway, the thing is, in the calculation, mod of A didn't figure out here. Okay, so Kanishka, I hope you have understood how you got A dot B equal to 6. Yeah, we have done dot product n number of times. And Anmol, just subtract the vectors correctly. Yeah. You can't keep making mistakes like this. Subtract A minus A parallel. It's 3 − 2i cap plus j cap minus of minus j cap. And a minus k cap minus of minus k cap. Okay, so is the first part clear now to all of you? Any more doubts in the first part? Okay, let's come to the second part then. Now in the second part, see, what we have been asked to find is the vector C. such that the modulus of the vector C is 5 units. Okay, C is perpendicular to B and lies in the plane of A and B. Okay, so this is the important thing. It lies in the plane of A and B. Okay, so let's redraw that diagram that we had of the vectors A and B. So suppose this was our vector B, okay. It's seen its magnitude was root 6, okay. And this was our vector A. Its magnitude after the correction was root 11, okay. And we had seen something interesting about this vector diagram or about this particular triangle. And that thing which was interesting was like this, that if we drop this perpendicular, then A cut a projection on B which was exactly equal to B. Okay. So based on that, we had seen that we got the projection of A perpendicular to B this vector. So this was A perpendicular and this was actually coinciding exactly with B, which was A parallel. Okay. So we also saw that the parallel component had a magnitude of root 6. And the perpendicular component was I cap plus 2 j cap. So it had a magnitude of root 5. Okay. So you can see that this triangle also fits in. Okay. Now see, in this we have to find a new vector. So in all of this, now we have to find a vector C which is perpendicular to B, okay, but in the plane of A and B. So first thing is, from this information, you try to figure out ki what is the unit vector of C, the direction of C kaisa hona chahiye. So think logically in the diagram and tell me where should the direction of C lie. In this diagram, where should C cap lie? You understanding my question, people? Magnitude of C to diya hua hai, but I'm asking that according to this information which I've circled, yes, what should be the direction which nahi Ansh, think again baba. Yes, very good Aman, that's correct. Are Kanish, how kya soch ke answer do baba. Yahan pe directly likha hua hai perpendicular to B and you are saying along the direction of B. To question ko contradict kar rahe ho aap. साफ साफ लिखा हुआ है क्वेश्चन में बेटा, इट इज परपेंडिकुलर टू बी, सो हाउ कैन यू से इट विल बी अलोंग बी. ओके, सो इट इज परपेंडिकुलर टू बी बट लाइंग इन द प्लेन ऑफ द बोर्ड. ना, इट इज लाइंग इन द प्लेन ऑफ द स्क्रीन बिकॉज दैट इज द स्क्रीन ऑफ ए एंड बी. हाँ, वेरी गुड, दैट्स करेक्ट नाउ कनिष्क. ओके, सो गुड, दैट्स करेक्ट नाउ. सो देखो, आई एम ड्रॉइंग इट इन द डायग्राम. So you see कि C का जो यूनिट वेक्टर है वो या तो ऐसे हो सकता है, C cap या तो ऐसे हो सकता है. सो परपेंडिकुलर टू B in the plane of A and B, or it can also be like this, na? It can also be the one below. ये भी तो हो सकता है ना, ये वाला भी हो सकता है. ओके, सो दिस डायरेक्शन इज अलोंग ए परपेंडिकुलर और माइनस ए परपेंडिकुलर, वन ऑप्शन पॉसिबल. गॉट इट? सो नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दैट सी how we'll calculate this vector now. So now it's just a matter of constructing the vector na. Mujhe uska direction pata lag gaya with respect to a perpendicular, aur mujhe uska magnitude pata hai. Now you can see that a perpendicular has a magnitude of root 5, and given that c has a magnitude of 5, therefore the vector c is either plus or minus of root 5 times the vector a perpendicular. Because if it is plus, then it is along a perpendicular. Okay. If it is minus, then it is along minus a perpendicular. So that's why I'm saying that the vector c will be either plus or minus of root 5 times a perpendicular, which as a vector we had seen was I cap plus 2 j cap. So c is plus minus of, although we can leave the answer this way also, no problem. Root 5 I cap plus 2 root 5 j cap. So this becomes the full answer of this part. Okay, so I'm just minimizing this bit for you people to go through carefully. So this is like a more typical kind of application of the concept of dot product. We used it to find projection, and then from that we are finding some other vector which has this kind of condition. Okay, beta. Okay, and so this is clear. Both in terms of direction and magnitude of C, now it's clear, no? So how we finally came to this answer? Okay, good. So I hope part A and part B are both clear to all of you. Now for the same question, we will do another part now. Okay. Yeah, finish writing this, it's fine. I'm just putting the other part here only. So after you finish writing down the second thing, the second part, now try to work out the third part. Yes, Akshat and Tantrish, your answers are correct. Mayank, your answer is not correct. You just verify what you've done, please. So for the third part, so far, Akshat, your answers are correct. Yeah, Siddhi, Prince, Sarah, your answers are correct for cross product. Udit, just check your answer once more. So anyway, let me work it out. So it's very simple really. For cross product, we'll just use that matrix method, determinant of matrix. So for A cross B, you have to substitute the second row with the components of A, the third row with the components of B. So in this case, that becomes three, one minus one, and two minus one minus one, right? So this is correct. Okay. Now you can really initially, when you're not used to doing this type of calculation, you can just do it very step by step. So next, break it up into, so remove I cap. So your first column is gone. So when your first column is gone, you're left with what? You're left with this matrix. Right? So that is one minus one minus one minus one. Okay. Then remove j cap, but remember, with the j cap term comes with an extra minus sign. Okay. And then you're left with, remove the second column. So you're left with first and third column. So the terms in the first and third column are 3 minus 1, 2 minus 1. Okay. And then remove k cap. K cap again comes with plus sign like I cap. Okay. So remove the third column. So first and second column terms here are 3, 1, 2 minus 1. Then calculate the determinant of each of these. So this is becoming minus 1 minus 1. So that's minus 2 I cap. Okay. Minus j cap into minus 3 plus 2. Okay. Plus k cap into minus 3 minus 2. So this is becoming minus 2 I cap. This will become minus one with an extra minus sign outside, plus j cap, okay, and minus 5 k cap. So this is your A cross B. Based on the vectors A and B, which were given above. Now, second thing, n cap, the unit vector perpendicular to the plane of A and B. Okay. So to find that, you use the fact that A cross B, and for that matter also B cross A, which is nothing but minus of A cross B, okay, is perpendicular to the plane of A and B. So use this little hint over here. There's like a hint I've given you. So using this, we'll be able to find this unit vector n cap, which is perpendicular to the plane of A and B. Yeah, Prince, I'm not following what you are saying. Huh? You're saying about the answer? Yeah, it's correct. But it can also be minus of that. So there are two possible unit vectors, you know, which are perpendicular to the plane of A and B. There are two possible unit vectors. Like if you draw the vectors A and B on the plane of the board, then the two unit vectors I'm talking about is the one either coming out or going in. So you'll have to take the unit vector of A cross B and then put a plus minus sign on it. Okay. So now see, you can understand that therefore n cap is either the unit vector of A cross B. Okay. Or minus of A cross B. Minus of A cross B is the same thing as B cross A. So that means n cap is plus or minus of A cross B divided by its own magnitude. So that is nothing but plus or minus of A cross B, which we had got above, that vector minus 2i cap plus j cap minus 5k cap divided by the mod of that same vector. This. So that is, it's going to be plus or minus of divided by square root of 2 square plus 1 square plus 5 square. So that's root 30. So that's telling me that n cap So this is the complete answer. Now you see, you can also verify this answer yourself very easily. Okay, so let's look at that also. To verify that n cap is the unit vector perpendicular to the plane of vectors A and B, first of all, check that magnitude of n cap should be 1. So that check that you can see, because magnitude of n cap will become mod of minus 2i cap plus j cap minus 5k cap by root 30. So that is the same thing as 1 by root 30 into mod of this. So but unless we made some bad calculation mistake, this thing is anyway going to verify. Okay, so this anyway, there's no problem with this. Now also the second thing is n cap should be perpendicular to A. So that means what? That n cap dot A should be 0. So check that it's happening or not. Okay. You can see that's 0. So that's happening. And similarly, the third thing you have to check is that n cap should be perpendicular to B. Okay, so in other words, n cap's dot product with B should be 0. So check that also. You see that's also happening. Okay. ये था भी, सो इनका डॉट प्रोडक्ट चेक करो, माइनस टू इंटू टू सो दैट्स माइनस फोर, देन माइनस वन प्लस फाइव सो दैट्स जीरो, सो दैट्स ऑल्सो करेक्ट. सो इनफैक्ट वी हैव टू चेक थ्री थिंग्स, यू नो, वी हैव टू चेक दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट्स अ यूनिट वेक्टर, वी हैवंट मेड एनी मिस्टेक विद द मैग्नीट्यूड, एंड सेकेंड ऑफ ऑल इट इज इट्स परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ बोथ ए एंड बी. सो इंडिविजुअली दैट यूनिट वेक्टर शुड बी परपेंडिकुलर टू ए, एंड इंडिविजुअली दैट यूनिट वेक्टर शुड बी परपेंडिकुलर टू बी. Okay, so hope this question is clear to all of you. Any doubts with this? Okay. Okay, let's move on to another question then. Okay, so too many of you are getting different answers. So let me verify this for you. Okay. So couple of ways of doing this. One is that because these vectors are very easy to draw, they are lying in the XY plane. So we can do this question geometrically. Okay. So first let us look at sort of geometrical approach to doing this question. Because they are lying in the XY plane and all that, and the angles and all are easy. So this is my XY plane. Okay. And now in this, the information given to me was like this, that the vector A was 12 y cap minus 12 root 3 j cap. Okay. So you can see that this vector has a magnitude of 24 and is at what angle with respect to the x-axis? At minus 60 degrees with respect to x-axis. It's in fourth quadrant because the y component is negative and the x component is positive. So if I draw the vector E, it should look like this. So the vector E should look something like this. Okay, understanding this, all of you? Now see the additional information given to me, which is very significant information here, is this, that vector B is such that is in the XY plane, first of all. Okay, and E cross B has a magnitude which is 1 by root 3 times A dot B. Okay, so this is another information which is given. So basically what we are getting from this information, this implies that AB sine theta is equal to 1 by root 3 times AB cos theta. So tan theta is 1 by root 3, or theta is tan inverse 1 by root 3 or 30 degrees, where theta is the angle between A and B. ठीक है, so ये पता लग गया मुझे. ठीक है, and what else is given, that A dot B, oh sorry, A cross B is 48. And this thing, and also given that A cross B is equal to 48. So that means AB sine theta is equal to 48. Okay. Now we had seen that A has a magnitude of 24, and we just saw that, okay, so this is sine 30 is equal to 48. So that means B is how much? It is 48 divided by 24 or 2. So this is one additional information I'm getting. Okay. So basically B is a vector of magnitude 2 units at 30 degrees with respect to E, okay, and in the XY plane. So now what can vector B be? So you can see there are two options that vector B can be. So the two options is that vector B can be so this is one possibility for vector B. Because this angle is 30. So B can be minus 2 j cap. Or another option for B will be that b could also be this vector here. Also be this. Okay. Where this angle is 30 degrees. Just two. So B could also be okay. 2 sine 30, that is I cap, minus 2 cos 30, that is root 3 j cap. Four है क्या? अच्छा, ओके, सॉरी सर, या आई मेक दैट करेक्शन. सो लेट्स, सो दिस वैल्यू विल चेंज अ लिटिल, बट सो जस्ट अ मिनट, लेट मी, सो दिस इज फोर, सो मैग्नीट्यूड इज फोर. So it is either minus 4 j cap, or in this direction it will be 4 cos, sorry, oh my mistake, wait a second, so the other possibility is that it is 4 cos 30, that is 2 root 3 I cap, minus 4 sine 30, so that is minus 2 j cap. So there are two possible values of vector b. There's not a single possible option, but there are. Now you can also verify this option. No. Both these options you can verify actually. So I'm leaving that to you to verify it. But we will also solve this by an algebraic method. Okay. So first of all, verify this. For each value. You should be getting E cross B's magnitude as 48, and you should be getting E dot B as 48 root 3. Where remember originally the vector E was what? The vector E was this one, 12 y cap minus 12 root 3 j cap. Okay. So you can verify both these things. Okay, so note this down in detail and do the verification yourself. Now, we will also do this question without drawing the diagram. That is the non-geometrical approach or the algebraic approach. But that is going to be a little bit more lengthy. Okay, people, anybody has done this question by the algebraic method? Fine, so let us go through the algebraic method also of solving this. So they will approach it this way, that the vector A was given to us as 12 I cap minus 12 root 3 J cap. Okay. And the vector B we don't know. So take the vector B as BX I cap plus BY J cap. So we have to find out BX and BY. Now given information to us is that E cross B has a magnitude which is 1 by root 3 times A dot B, which is equal to 48. Okay. So from here you can see that E cross B is 2 dimensions. Okay. So it is 12 BY minus, sorry, plus ho jayega 12 root 3 BX K cap. Okay. Or that is A cross B. So that means mod of A cross B is okay, and that is equal to 48. So that's my equation one. Okay. And second, you can see that A dot B is equal to 12 I cap minus 12 root 3 J caps dot product with BX I cap plus BY J cap. Okay. So that is 12 BX minus 12 root 3 BY. And that is equal to root 3 times 48, okay, because of this information given. So that becomes my second equation. Now solving the two, we'll get Vx and By. Okay. Actually, there are two possible solutions here. Okay. This is where one has to be a little bit careful. See, A cross B to ye aa gaya. But yahan pe, this thing, that E cross B's magnitude is 48. This actually involves two things. Okay, so just understand one thing here. Mod of A cross B is equal to 48. Okay, it means that 12 into by plus root 3 bx can be plus or minus of 48. Okay, so actually this equation will reduce to this. So it means that by plus root 3 bx can be plus or minus of 4, both. This should be my equation 1 instead of this. So these type of questions are a little bit extra tricky, and you have to be careful about these things while solving. Okay. We're taking that case where it's plus. So this case will give us the solution that, as you can see, this is the solution that we're getting from case 1. Now, likewise, there will also be a solution that we'll get from case 2. So case 2 mera kya tha? That A cross B is minus 48 k cap. Okay. So that was giving me that 12 into this thing here. 12 into by plus root 3 bx is minus 48. This is my equation 1. And equation 2 is that a dot b is that thing, 48 root 3. So bx minus root 3 by is equal to 4 root 3. That's my equation 2, you can see. So now solving these, we will get that by will come out to be minus 4 and bx will come out to be 0. You can see that solution is fitting here. Okay. So these are the possible solutions. Okay, so I'll just minimize this so that you can go through this. So we have discussed some, you know, more extreme type of questions today in complexity level, but using these questions, you will be able to tackle most of the questions of your exercise 3 and 4 now. Okay, so that's the reason we've done it. Okay, now we have, as I told you, we have another session coming up for exclusively for doubts this week itself. I don't remember which day it is. I think Thursday or Saturday, one of those days. So please keep all your doubts from yes, you should write all this down. So please keep all your doubts ready from the major test 2 as well as the exercises. Now please look at completing exercise 2 and 3 at least. Okay, eventually to complete all 4 exercises. From exercise 1, I think we've discussed most of the questions, so you'll not have difficulty completing that. But exercise 2 and 3, please attempt all the questions and also go through all the questions of the major test again, so that next lecture we can complete all these doubts. They are equal to the method. You can see geometrical method mein bhi yahi aaya tha beta, yahi aaya tha. Minus 4 j cap was one solution and 2 root 3 I cap minus 2 j cap was the other solution. That's what we are getting here. Exactly the same solution, Ansh. Okay, pay attention. Huh? Okay. So that's it for today's class, people. I will send you the notes and things, so don't worry about that. Okay, but as I said that this week, please try to make sure you attempt all the questions of exercise 2 and 3 from your module and also go through your test paper once more. Okay. But Ansh, you understood, huh? You will get opposite of that actually. You will get what I've written over there. You will get 2 root 3 I cap minus 2 j cap. Yeah, today's mentorship session, whatever other doubts you have in general, you can discuss. But the test paper doubts and also from your module, the doubts I will be discussing in the doubt lecture we have this week. Okay, so that's it for today, people. All the best.